Silent Bob say yay, cause it's Jay. And Silent Bob and Bob go woo. They got old, but they still rock. Jay doesn't shoot up, and that's rough. Bob still gets cake. They should have died. They're still alive. Let's get these motherfuckers out on stage. Welcome to Jay and Silent Bob Get Old. Now here are your hosts, Jason Mewes and Kevin Smith. Holy shit.
Not Jason Mewes and Kevin Smith. Well, you've been here? No.
I've been close. I did a show at Crystal Lake. Crystal Lake is close, right?
Wait. Crystal Lake? Like,
yeah, motherfucking Jason country and shit. They got it here, too.
It was fun last night. It was fun. We haven't gotten the costumes right since. I mean, we shot a video recently where we put them on. But again, it's like we put them on, we shot the video, we took them off. It was fun, like, getting into them and, like, hanging out. We got into them at the place we're staying and then, like, stayed in them, like, half the time. The music?
Do you hear music?
I do. I've been hearing it the whole time. It's really, I don't know where it's from, though. It's a little distracting. It's like, doo-doo-doo. It's like Charlie Brown.
I think I went away. I was like, I'm having a stroke in McHenry. Because I was like hearing music out of nowhere. Thank God you heard it as well. Sorry, go on with your story.
No. I've been hearing it the whole time you were telling your McHenry's story. At 9 years old, I wanted to be like, doo-doo-doo-doo. It was like it had a soundtrack. Your story had a soundtrack.
It's the only way the story was tolerable. You're like, thank God it had a soundtrack.
It was cool getting in the costumes and hanging out and like walking around movies, because not only were we in the costumes, we're in movies. And you know, it was awesome. Like, people came to movies dressed up. We had a really awesome cock knocker, and then
that was you. Holy shit, we met you, man.
it was Bartleby, right?
Bartleby, yes. and cock knocker.
And it's so awesome because it's been so long. And just to be honest, on Dogma, and we'll talk about some of this later, but on Dogma, I was not in the best of shape with drugs and stuff. But as soon as I saw it.
Physically, you were in great shape.
Oh, but yeah, it was all right. You
look good, man.
And my brain was all right in the sense that I did memorize all my dialogue.
Yes.
But the problem was, I realized that the hindrance was that every time there was like, all right, we have to put another light up, it'll be 2 minutes, I'd be like, I have to go to the bathroom, which really I didn't. I wanted to go to the bathroom so I could be like, you know, and do stuff. And so my brain, all I thought about was getting to the bathroom next time. But again, I had a blast. But
what a weird, like if you talk to anyone else in Dogma, like, what are your memories? They're like, oh, I remember working with George Carlin. I remember working with an Alan Rickman. Ask you, like, what are your memories? You're like, I always wanted to go to the bathroom so badly.
It was
part of the reason I was able to convince Jason to make the trip was because I was just like, they're shooting the Batman in Chicago. And he was like, holy fuck, can we go? And I was like, I don't know anybody in the cast, but we can fucking tweet at Matt Reeves and see if maybe he'll bring us to set. And he was like, all right. And when we got here, the Batman had left Chicago. So I didn't have the heart to tell him for the first 2 days and stuff. And he was like, when are we going to the Batman? I'm like, soon. Soon. And so, then I had to eventually let him down. And Gotham City is gone.
Instead, he fucking, the whole drive here is, what's that, about an hour?
Yeah.
His GPS is like, it's Batman. So the whole way here, I'm like, oh my God, check that. Watch out. This is like Gotham City. There's an accident ahead. You know, different stuff like that. It's the Batman voice for Waze?
Waze,
yeah. So it's like the whole way here we're listening to Batman. But it's like, it's sort of like his voice takes over. So I'm like,
and it's Kevin Conroy from Batman the Animated Series, which is like the calm voice that you want to hear in any tense moment in your life. Particularly, it's not all that tense, but like, we're not from the area, so it's like we're going to a strange place. So you want as much guidance, a steady hand, a surety as you can, and the voice of fucking Kevin Conroy's Batman could literally tell me to be like, go kill your wife in her sleep, and I'd be like, yes, Batman.
Like, you know, when I was away and she first saw it, her theme song, my wife said she'd want to play it every time in this car. Remember me. when you're so far away.
Oh my God, your kid.
Me.
You better be careful. Your kid's gonna wind up on a stripper pole, man. Like she's already fucking like being nostalgic for her father. She can't see. He's always on trips and shit.
Yeah, she did. She did. She like wanted to hear that.
You've
song.
Seen the movie, right? That Remember Me song is about someone who's fucking dead. You understand that, right?
I know, but I was out of town. I was away. I wasn't dead. But she does understand. She
Maybe
says,
you show her Frozen instead.
Well,
you know
she
what
loves
I'm saying?
Frozen. She loves Frozen too. But she.
But when she wants to rub it in, she turns on the cocoa.
She's
like, remember me.
Exactly. Don't leave. Don't
remember
leave.
This when I start dating shitty men. Remember this.
Oh, come on, man. I'm never going to want to leave the house again. No.
All of our shows going to be me live on stage and you up on the screen live streaming going, hold on, I got to keep an eye on my daughter. Stop watching Coco.
Because we were talking about the other day, because Logan's always like, when's my birthday? When's my another birthday? She can't wait for her birthday for presents and stuff.
Kid but understands death, doesn't understand a yearly birthday.
But she knows it's coming up. And I'm like, hey, it's coming up soon. Don't worry. Yours is first, then mommy's. It's cool because Logan's is in April. Jordan's is in May and mine's in June.
Yes.
But as we're saying that, I'm like, holy shit, I'm going to be 47 in like 7 months or whatever it is. And then I think, holy shit, 47, then almost 50. To me, 50.
Be careful.
It just, no, it just for me, it doesn't seem, in my
don't
brain.
Don't seem possible.
It doesn't. And in my head, it doesn't seem at all. Like that I'm in the 50. Don't get me wrong. Sometimes I think when I wake up and I'm like, oh, my back or something that I'm like, oh, I can feel my age getting older. When I look in the mirror and see my crow's feet, I'm like, oh, I'm getting older.
Or but when you prematurely ejaculate on the shower floor.
Exactly. I'm like, oh, well, you know, but my, I just, it doesn't seem 50 to me. Just seems like something I wouldn't have ever made to it. My goal was to hopefully make it to like, I want to make it to 90, like, Connery or Lee, you know, I'm hoping anyway. But it seems like such
a
far
Stanley.
Road. Stanley, a Sean Connery.
Stan made it to almost 96.
I know. Dude, I was looking, there was a woman on my Google. You know when you pick your phone up and Google just throws up things? It's funny because you're always in the front. And I'm like, oh my God, look what happened. And Jordan, I'm like, no, that's just because you probably have searched Jay and Bob or something.
Right.
Anyway, I didn't know that. But anyway, you know, underneath that will be something else, news and something else. And there was it was like 107-year-old passes away today. You know, the great age of 107. I'm like, holy shit! I didn't know there was a 107-year-old out there. I thought like the oldest was like maybe ever 102, possibly, and maybe you know 50, 100 years ago there was a hundred. So, I looked up, like, how old is the oldest woman? And it shows the top 10. And I didn't realize there's like 10 women out there. They're all women too, that are from the 104 all the way up to 116 years old. Can you imagine being 116?
I'm glad that's where this story was going, because I was honestly thinking you were like, there are 10 women out there who are over 100 and I plan to fuck them all. And so it's about now that we turn to Jason and say, how long you been clean and sober?
10 years, 5 months today. Thank you. You know, because usually it's like we see people, we can see them, and I can see if someone's smiling or laughing when I'm saying something or not. And it, for me, it's like, of course, the lights, obviously, right then was very nice that people are like, yes. But the whole time prior to that, they could all be like, his fucking asshole. I don't want to hear about him coming in 2 seconds. We should go home and fuck, baby, and lie. You could show him who is a real man.
I would imagine if they were like, this asshole, I don't want to hear about him comes in 2 fucking seconds, they would have quit our shit 25 years ago.
Sure, I have been coming for 2 seconds for 20 years.
Yeah, it's been part of your fucking brand. But he was like, hey, man, we like it. We would like to work with you again. What do you want to do? And they were interested in seeing if I wanted to adapt books and stuff. They had some pretty high-end material. And I said, I'll be honest with you, Jasper, the only thing I'm really interested in is something that you guys have of mine, which I would really like to do something with. I'd really like to go back to. And he was like, Mallrats? I said, yes, I would like to make a Mallrats sequel. So next year in 2021, we're going to be making a sequel called Twilight of the Mallrats, ladies and gentlemen. Twilight of the Mallrats is a beat for beat, like sequel to the real Mallrats. It's the movie it's meant to be. All the characters come back. There's no fucking terrorism and shit. We've exercised that muscle in Jay and Silent Bob Reboot. It resembles what Mallrats was. Mallrats was just a story of two dudes who get broken up with and they spend their day at the mall. And by the end of it, they wind up going back out with their girlfriends and stuff. So structurally, it's become a lot closer to that, which I'm happy about because when people finally see it, they'll be like, yeah, I guess if you were going to do a sequel to Mallrats, this would make sense. Whereas the other one, I think people would have been like, what the fuck did that have to do with Mallrats other than you put it in a mall?